Hello students, today we will study about the balancing of redox reactions. First we will study the oxidation number method. See, suppose we are having this equation here where KMnO4 it is reacting with this oxalic acid in presence of sulfuric acid, we'll get K2SO4 MnSO4 and from here we'll get CO2NH2O. So this is the equation, and we will balance this equation by using the oxidation number method. See, steps I have not written separately, here only I have explained you with an example that how we will balance it by using this method. So first we'll write the oxidation number of all the elements present over here. Like, we know that oxidation number of K is +1, of O it is -2. So first we'll calculate out the oxidation number of manganese. See, it is -2, -2 into 4 will be -8. -8, it is +1, means -7. When this -7 will go right inside, it will become +7. It means manganese is having oxidation number +7. Similarly, H +1, O -2. Here we have to calculate the oxidation number of sulfur. So O is 4, 2s are -8. This is 2, 1s are +2. -8 +2, it will be -6. And -6, when it will come to right hand side, it will become +6. Similarly, this 4, 2s are -8. And like this, we'll calculate, it will become 2x. So it is half of 6, that will be 3. So like this, we'll calculate out the oxidation number of all these elements. Now see step 3. The atoms showing change in oxidation number, if we'll see, like K is having same oxidation number, manganese, if we'll see, its oxidation number is changed. Here from +7, it is +2. It means gain of electron is taking place. Yes. Rest are having same oxidation number, only the oxidation number of carbon is changed here. See, from +3, it is becoming +4. It means loss of electron. A single electron. Here gain of 5 electron is taking place, and here a loss of a single electron is taking place. Now see, the atoms showing the change in the oxidation number are manganese from +7 to +2 and carbon from +3 to +4. Thus KMnO4 is the oxidizing agent. Since it is gaining electron, it means itself it is getting reduced, and the substance which get reduced itself, it is an oxidizing agent. And this oxalic acid, this H2C2O4, it is a reducing agent. Okay, now fourth step. Here just what we have done, we have just identified the atoms which are showing change in their oxidation numbers. Now in step 4, the atom of manganese are equal on both sides. See, manganese here too it is 1, and here also 1. In order to equalize the number of atoms of carbon, CO2 should be multiplied by 2. See, it's C2. So if we need to balance this, so we'll put 2 here to balance this. So the equation, it will become like this. We'll put 2 here. Now in step 5, the KMnO4, in KMnO4, an atom of manganese, it should gain 5 electrons to decrease its electronic configuration from +7 to +2. Okay, and H2C2O4, each atom of carbon should lose 1 electron to increase its oxidation number from +3 to +4. So here gain of electron is taking place because it is changing from +7 to +2. Okay, and here loss of 1 electron per molecule is taking place. So total of electrons gained by one atom of manganese, it is 5, and total number of electrons lost by two atoms of carbon, since two atoms are here, it will be 1 into 2, that is 2. 5 and 2 are there. To equalize electron, KMnO4 should be multiplied by 2 and H2C2O4 by 5. Because we need to equalize the number of electrons here, na? So we'll multiply it by 5 and multiply this by 2. The equation will become like this: 2 KMnO4 plus H2 plus 5, and this. Okay, So here see what happened. It became 10 here, because we need to equalize the number of these also. So it becomes 10 here. Now see, balancing the above equation with respect to other atoms other than hydrogen and oxygen. We leave hydrogen and oxygen, and apart from these we'll balance all the other atoms which are present over here. So if we'll see 2K, here also 2K, manganese are 2 here too, oxygen 4 2s are oxygen we need not to balance here. See, sulfur 3 atoms are here, and sulfur if we'll talk about here, sulfur it is 2 plus 1, this is 3. Okay, now I feel all the atoms are balanced. Carbon also it is balanced. Now it is having 10 here, it is also balanced. Now in last we'll balance hydrogen and oxygen. Only hydrogen and oxygen are left, and if we'll see, it will be balanced by writing 8 here. If we'll write here in front of H2O, all the atoms of hydrogen and oxygen will be balanced. So first of all, what we have to do here in this oxidation number method, first we'll write all the oxidation numbers of all the atoms which are present in the reaction. Then we will find out which of the atoms are showing change in their oxidation numbers. Then in order to equalize the atoms of those numbers, those atoms which are showing change in their oxidation numbers will balance the number of atoms of those elements only. Okay, then we know that according to the oxidation number, the charges which are there, like it should gain 5 electrons, it is losing 1 electron. So we have to equalize the number of electrons here. So in order to equalize the numbers, it will be multiplied by 5, it will be multiplied by 2. So we'll balance it like that. And then we will balance the number of all the other elements other than oxygen and hydrogen, and then at last we'll balance the remaining 2 elements which are oxygen and hydrogen. At last we'll balance them. So this is how we can balance a redox reaction by using the oxidation number method.